Today marks the last of the tranches of announcement subsequent to Prime Minister's address to the nation. In fact, I'd like to start by quoting Prime Minister's some words of Prime Minister's speech that day, because what I'm planning to say today is very much pegged to that aspect of his speech. And I quote, "As a nation today, we stand at a very crucial juncture." He spoke in Hindi, and a version of it in English has been translated. I'm using that. "As a nation, we stand at a very crucial juncture. Such a big disaster is a signal for India. It has brought a message and an opportunity." Unquote. He also used the expression crisis and an opportunity. That again leads to me to refer to his expression that we need now to build an Atmanirbhar Bharat. So, laying the foundation for what I want to say today, a little again quote from the Prime Minister. Quote, "In order to prove the resolve of a self-reliant India, land, labor, liquidity and laws, land, labor, liquidity and laws all have been emphasized in this package." So, a message from the pandemic, the challenges that it throws, the crisis and the challenge, and also looking at a self-reliant Bharat, an India which is going to be strong enough to meet the global challenges, but primarily looking at land, labor, liquidity and laws to bring that strength back to India and build a Atmanirbhar India. So, in the last 4 days of announcements, particularly the last 2 days, have had several reforms addressing the land, labor, liquidity and the laws. Today, we will be continuing in that series. PM also had said, "Jaan hai to jahan hai." Soon after announcing the lockdown, we had come with a PM Garib Kalyan package in order to immediately reach out to those who wanted food, who need food. We were not doing a favor to them, it was our duty. So we quickly went in to give next 3 months the requirement of grains as per the PDS, plus free grains also, because we didn't want them to scout for money to go and search for grains. Pulses were also given for 3 months in advance. And here, I would want to say a word in appreciation of the efforts that the Food Corporation of India, NAFED and the state governments all together put in facing the logistics challenge that this posed, upfront giving all the grains and the pulses as promised to everybody who needed it as per the cards in every nook and corner of the country. It was a logistic challenge. Although the FCI and the NAFED and the state governments are quite adept at doing it, but all at one go upfront was a major issue because huge quantities had to go. But notwithstanding the lockdown, I again want to say the FCI, the NAFED and the state governments all came into the picture, made sure that the quantity of grains were lifted and gave them the workers who couldn't travel back, who actually could procure the grains from their cards. But there were also workers who couldn't go back to their homes, who stayed in the camps, because PM had very clearly said early, in one of his early messages, stay where you are. and state governments ensured that they prepared meal. NGOs participated in this. Charitable organizations also made sure that these workers who are not able to go back home are attended to. Many employers also kept their workers in their own premises and gave them food and place to be. The PM Garib Kalyan used the technology available and therefore was able to do direct benefit transfer of cash for the various categories. I just want to quote some of these numbers now before I begin today's issue, because of the size of what is shown in these figures. The number of people to whom directly to their accounts money could reach because technology, direct benefit transfer technology, was in time adopted and implemented with such missionary zeal over the last 4 years. Otherwise, this wouldn't have been possible at all. PM Kisan beneficiaries as of 16th May, I'm strictly talking about the announcements and their impact. One-time transfer of 2,000 rupees each has reached 8.19 crore farmers, and that amount is about 16,394 crores. NSAP beneficiary, the old age and others, first installment 2.812 crores of people, 1,405 crores of rupees in the first installment, again 1,402 in the second installment. The target was to give away 3,000 crores. And that's almost nearly achieved. Jan Dhan account holding women under the PM Garib Kalyan were credited into 20 crore people's accounts. And that amounts to 10,025 crores of rupees. The building and construction workers received their financial support amounting to 3,950.35 crores. And their number, the building and construction workers' number, is 2.20 crores. Imagine each one of these numbers and their implication in terms of size. And all of them received the money directly into their accounts purely because DBT was possible. 6.81 Ujjwala Yojana cylinders have reached the beneficiaries. And they were free cylinders because we had promised up to 3 cylinders in those 3 months. To over 12 lakhs of EPFO members have benefited by the online withdrawal of non-refundable advance, and that amounts to 3,660 crores. So I can further go with the numbers, but just to highlight what the technology-driven DBT has given us at a time of emergency, a pandemic. And that is something which I want to draw your attention to. We immediately responded by giving food grains, cooking gas, cash, where it was required, and immediately, that is. And most of them were front-loaded also. When the lockdown got extended, free grains and dal was also given for a further 2 months more, free grains and dal was also given for 2 months more. And when it was really possible to have the workers go from the camps that they were in to their respective villages, trains were allowed, and state governments were requested to request for trains from the various stations that they wanted, so that once they brought the workers into that area, to that station, from that station they could be taken to their respective states. The cost of this travel, 85% of it was borne by the central government. The rest is 15% was with the state governments, 85% was borne by the central government. During the travel in the train, food was also given to the workers. So why am I elaborating all this? Just because, remember, Jaan hai to jahan hai. So immediately to make sure that the lives are given the first priority and attention, we ensured that this was extended. But now, it is important also to provide every support when in a changed post-COVID era, livelihoods will also have to come into their fullest play. So when the lockdown gets lifted, and when businesses, after facing severe, stressful conditions of business, will be coming back to say, can I start my work back again? Can I get my workers back? Or do I have the money to buy the raw materials? Is it enough for me to pay the wages which is due? All kinds of considerations are going to come up, and many of them may also wonder if they were reaching a stage of bankruptcy. So all this has been kept in mind when we are addressing the issues of land, labor, liquidity and the laws. So today, and like the days earlier, the 4 days earlier, our attempt is to make sure that, like the way we gave in PM Garib Kalyan, we attend to Jaan, but also make sure that environment is all right. Now for everybody to start protecting their work, their businesses, their homes and everything else. Today, I have 7 such steps to tell you, and the order in which I'm saying them are: the first one is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee scheme. Second is on health, and both in rural and urban, and together with it I put an during the COVID period education related steps that have been taken. So that's the second. Third is on businesses and COVID. Fourth is on decriminalization of the Companies Act. Fifth is talking about ease of doing business and related matters. Sixth is on public sector enterprises related matters and the policy thereof. Seventh, state governments and resources related to state governments. So these will be these are the steps which we are taking, 7 of them under these headings. And the last, of course, I will be coming to tell you about the 20 lakhs.
Namaskar. आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान में माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने हम सबके सामने बात रखी, देश के प्रति संबोधन किया। उसको देखते हुए हमने पिछले कुछ दिनों में वो कदम उठाए जो रचनात्मक और उपयोगी हों। वी हैव टेकन स्टेप्स विच वर कंस्ट्रक्टिव एंड प्रोडक्टिव, और योजनाबद्ध तरीके से हमने काम किया है। वी हैव वर्क विद अ टारगेटेड अप्रोच इन द लास्ट कपल ऑफ मंथ्स। और जैसा वित्त मंत्री जी ने कहा और माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने भी कहा कि चुनौतीपूर्ण समय में भी संकट में अवसर देखने का काम किया है, और पिछले 5 दिनों में उन सबकी रूपरेखा आप सबके सामने रखी है। आत्मनिर्भर भारत का 20 लाख करोड़ का पैकेज और इसके साथ जो रिफॉर्म्स हम एक बड़ा बदलाव लाने के लिए और संबल प्रदान करने के लिए लाए हैं, वो पिछले कुछ दिनों में उसकी रूपरेखा हमने आपके सामने रखी। इस पैकेज में सभी वर्गों का ध्यान रखने का प्रयास किया गया है, चाहे वो किसान हो, बागवान हो, महिला हो, मजदूर हो, उद्यमी हो, युवा हो, इन सबके लिए ही, व्यापारी कर्मचारी तक के लिए भी उसका इसमें ध्यान रखा गया। और सबसे पहले ध्यान स्वास्थ्य की सुविधाएं देने के लिए प्रधानमंत्री जी ने घोषणा की थी, फिर प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण पैकेज को हम लेकर आए 1,70,000 करोड़ का, और उसमें भी अगर आप आज तक देखें तो सबसे पहले राशन देने का काम, अनाज देने का काम जो पूरे देश भर की राज्य की सरकारों और यूनियन टेरिटरीज के माध्यम से किया, तो 80 करोड़ लोगों को मुफ्त में 5 किलो गेहूं और चावल देने के लिए हमने इस योजना को लेकर आए, और इनके परिवारों को 1-1 किलो दाल देने का काम भी किया, और प्रति व्यक्ति 5-5 किलो गेहूं चावल। इसके अलावा गैस की कमी ना हो, ऐसे 6 करोड़ 81 लाख रसोई गैस के सिलेंडर, और इसमें 8,429 करोड़ रुपया इन बेनिफिशरीज के खाते में डायरेक्ट बेनिफिशरीज ट्रांसफर के माध्यम से किया गया है।